means I don't feel means I don't feel uncomfortable. It's okay. Means you can say, of course, I want to drink a cup of tea in the morning after my breakfast or lunch. But if suppose I miss taking that cup of tea, I have no problem or I feel no problem.
Do you know what happened with me? If I don't drink coffee or tea, I think I'm like addicted to what is called caffeine.
Yes, I know
So
that because actually your body needs it. Because when you take that a cup of coffee, so caffeine is there. So it when it goes into your body, it actually generates a kind of hormone, and that gives you a kind of relief or comfort or solace. So that's why you need it. So when you don't get a cup of coffee and it's the time for you to get that hormone and you don't get, then your body actually becomes lethargic. That's why you need, and not it is not with you actually, it is with 90 or almost 100% of the people. Who are in the habit of taking a cup of coffee or tea in the morning? They even some of the people they feel headache.
Oh, I have severe headache, yeah, since I'm fasting. So I don't get a chance to, I don't drink like, during fast. So I'm getting even migraine. I notice I'm having migraine or I don't know, stress pain or migraine. Do you have any home remedies to get rid of this migraine?
Migraine, definitely you should go for pranayama yoga as earlier I told you.
Okay.
Actually migraine means actually there is a nerve in your brain. It is means it swells. That's why you feel headache and it is severe. Even some of the people who have means migraine, they feel like vomiting. So pranayama is very helpful. Otherwise, in allopathy, there is no treatment for that. They just give you symptomatic treatment. Symptomatic means symptoms, like symptoms
Symptom
means
okay.
जैसा आपको हो रहा है वैसी दवा दे देते हैं. लाइक यू से आई एम फीलिंग हेडेक, दे गिव यू पेन किलर. और एंड इफ यू से दैट मीन आई एम फीलिंग लूज मोशन और आई एम हैविंग लूज, देन दे गिव यू द टेबलेट फॉर लूज मोशन. They don't go into the cause actually, that why it is happening, why you are suffering. So that's why it is called means they prescribe tablets, medicines on the basis of symptoms, not on the basis of disease. That if you have fever, why you have fever, that cause is to be found out. And that is to be treated, not fever. Fever is not a disease. Fever is a symptom of something happening, something wrong has happened or is going to happen with you. It is this signal, you can see. So that's why I think you should go for pranayama and yoga, anulom vilom, kapalbhati. Definitely that is going to help you a lot.
Yeah, I will go for it. So I did today. I did my 25 question as well as my daily routine.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, what is the first question?
Okay. What is the first question? Is why is it important to sleep 8 hours a day?
Okay. I ask you that question. You answer it. Why is it necessary for a person to have sleep for 8 hours a day? Why is it important? Why is it necessary?
Okay. It is very important to sleep 8 hours a day because the others, like 16 hours we are working. We are working very hard. We are like traveling, going into office, taking the stress, doing all hard work. So after, you know, in daytime, after spending 16 hours, we do need some rest. So for that rest, we should be going into our bed by 8 and try to get up as early as possible, like 5 o'clock. So that's how I think it's important to have 8 hours sleep. What do you think? But how do you answer this question?
Okay. Actually, you know, definitely that body, or you know, the structure, and we have got organs, and definitely it's a machine. Actually, you know, it's a kind of machine, and it is working itself. Means our body, I'm talking about our body. So when we work continuously, like we get up, we go, we you know, we take bath or we take exercise, sometimes we have food, means continuously we work, we go to office, come back, we cook food or whatever, means so when we are awaking, means when we are not sleeping, so when we are awaking, actually during that process, many toxins are deposited in our body. Like means definitely toxins are there, and toxins are generated and they are deposited in our body, in kidney, in our blood, urine. So what happens when you go to sleep, then your body and mind, they have rest. So during that process, during that means process of sleeping, all the toxins, they come into your urinary bladder or your intestines and all. So when you get up in the morning, all the toxins are released from your body, and that's why you feel energetic again. And why you feel sleepy? Because toxins are there. And that's why, you know, a patient who is suffering from means any disease, then patients, they always like to sleep. You know why? Because toxins are there in their body. That's why they want to sleep. So sleeping.
Toxic means zahar.
Yes, you can say. Zahar.
And intoxic?
Yeah.
Toxic, zahar and intoxic? Not zahar.
Toxin. Intoxicant means jo intoxicants, like we say, jo koi nashe mein ho.
Okay.
Nashile. Intoxicants matlab nashili cheeze, maybe wine, maybe cigarette. But toxins are means jo, what we should say, a kind of poison, you can, but that is not poison, but these are impurities, and these are generated inside our body, and these are to be released. and these can be released by our sweat, urine, excrete. So when you get up in the morning or whenever you get up, you go to urinate, you go to toilet and you sweat. So that means, it means these toxins are released through all these process. So you feel fresh. So that's why it is recommended by the science or by the medical science to sleep at least for 8 hours in 24 hours. But I don't sleep for 8 hours.
How many hours?
I only sleep for 5 hours.
How do you maintain them? All those functions.
I don't feel sleepy. Five or maximum six. Suppose five, and in daytime sometimes, if I get time, then I take a nap.
Half an hour nap or 1 hour nap?
Maybe one, or it is for an hour, or it is for just for half an hour. It depends actually. But most of the time I take a nap for an hour.
Okay, second question. How can you grow your hair again?
Did you like my answer?
Oh, it was great. I mean, you know, whatever you said, I cannot explain. You know what I've been doing?
Yeah, it's okay, but it should be answered in that way, I think.
It should be answered in that manner. So, okay, second question is, how can you grow your hair again without hair transplant? And how do you stop hair falling? What can help you to stop those hair falling things?
First you answer, then I'll answer.
Okay, my answer is we have hair falling because of stress, I think. And yeah, mostly we take a shower in hot water and we do not realize until, you know, we feel like we are getting bald. And once we realize, my hair is falling, then we try to find the cause. And mostly we cannot find those things like why my hair is falling. It's because of what? It's because of nutrition, it's because of stress, or because of those shampoos which are made with chemicals. So we keep on thinking, and with that, worse, then we get some more stress, and again, it just make it worse. And then, so what I would say, now I found a very good, I found one very good remedy. So I mix up all the essential oils with onion juice. So I'm using it now. So I think I will improve and I will grow my hair again.
You are right, but the cause behind actually hair fall. And in young age actually, the people means they're not very much aware of all these things because they are busy in their routine, but they don't take care of all these things. Means they don't take care of their hair. So that's why, or sometimes they have tensions and their schedule is very hectic, so that's the reason that they are in tension, or their routine is very hectic, their mind is always working even during sleeping. So the first thing is that means they should have very managed routine. And not actually, you know, there is a word or there is a proverb that there should not be any hurry, worry or curry in your life. This is not the matter of laughing, but this is true. Actually, my father used to say that. My father always used to tell me that there should not be any hurry, worry and curry in anybody's life if we really want to lead a happy life. So it means we should try to have a very managed routine, and there should be everything should be in order. Means if suppose it's the time for you to sleep, you should go to sleep. If it's the time for you to have food, you should have food. Means there should not be a big gap. Means suppose if you have breakfast at 8 o'clock, means in a particular situation you may be late to have your breakfast, no problem. But if you do it every day, if there is no particular time for you to have breakfast, then definitely your body, or you know, the cycle of your body will be disturbed, and you won't have proper digestion, you won't have proper sleep, you are not going to have good appetite, and you should be aware of your food also, that what kind of food you are having. So that is also very important. The first thing is that you should be happy, you should try to be happy, and the second thing, your food should be full of all the nutrients like minerals, vitamins, and you know, little bit carbohydrates, proteins, everything should be there.
You know why I was laughing when you said curry? And you know, curry is like you know people every single day they are having curry.
Yeah, it's okay. I know that you are laughing, that's why. So hurry means why you should be hurry, why should be in hurry means you should always be patient in doing your work, and there should not be anybody. Leave everything to God. If you believe in God, why to worry? You are doing your job, that's all. What you are means going to have as a result, that is not in your hand. So why to worry? And stop eating curry, because it is full of oil and spices and all. It is not good for health. Yeah.
So what do you eat then, if you don't eat curry? What do you eat? It's like you eat raw food or?
And I'll tell you that. First, let me complete. So actually, you know, it's okay. You are using oil or different means. You are adopting some different methods. But you are applying all these things locally. Means you are using oil or any ointment or something to stop hair fall. But these are means, you know, the temporary remedies. It's okay, you may go for it, but the permanent solution for that problem is to maintain your routine, and you should have balanced diet. It should be of means mineral or whatever I have already told you. So you should have balanced diet, you should take little bit exercise also, and of course pranayam and yoga, it is also very helpful. You should have good blood circulation, and that you can have by taking exercise. So all these things are going to help you. Is the combined effort of all these things is going to help you to stop hair fall, and when you stop, then you will have growth also. You should have, you know, raw vegetable, fruit. These are also very important. So that's why, actually, you know, as you are asking me why, what I eat, I simply eat multigrain chapati, as I told you, I think earlier. I prefer multigrain flour.
Meat, so, not is it, it is available in India, multigrain?
Yeah, it is available on every shop.
Okay.
Multigrain means not only wheat, maize, barley, and gram. Means 7 grains are there. Seven grains, and not only one wheat. But most of the people they prefer wheat flour only.
Yeah.
It is full of carbohydrates. But when you eat all these multigrain flour, the chapati is very, very tasty. It's very good. It is good for digestion. It is full of fiber also. So I eat that. Even, you know, dalia? So that we also use, you know, multigrain. So I use that, and in the morning I take only a big cup of curd, yogurt, and then I use soya cheese.
Soya cheese is a white?
Yes.
Comes in white color?
Yes. Not proper white, it is like off white.
Okay, soya cheese, okay.
You know soya cheese?
I don't know, I just saw soya. You know the green, it's like cilantro?
Soya is a kind of grain, you can say. And okay. The cheese, paneer, jisko bolte ho, paneer. That is prepared with that. So it is very good for health. It is a very rich source of protein.
So you are vegetarian?
Yes. So that is a very great and rich source of protein. Soya cheese. So I have 50 grams or 60 grams of soya cheese. And multigrain chapati, and a cup of yogurt. And in yogurt, I just use small pieces of onion also into it, because onion, you know, onion is very good in summer. In India, it's summer. In Pakistan, it's summer. You know,
so it's very hot.
Yeah, yes, it's very hot, and so we have to take onion, raw onion, just to stop the effect of, just to prevent ourselves from heat waves.
Heat waves or dehydration also.
Yeah. So, this is my, you know, breakfast or lunch. I take my lunch, you can say, at 8:30 in the morning. This is my lunch, this is my breakfast, this is my everything.
Lunch, breakfast, you take it at 11:30?
No. I take my lunch at 8:30 India time.
8:30, you take your lunch or breakfast?
That is breakfast or lunch, what you call it, it's your choice. But okay. I take full meal. So I call it lunch.
Okay.
I don't take breakfast. This is my lunch.
Okay, and what is your next meal after that?
After that means after 10 or 11, I'll take a cup of tea.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, around at 2 p.m., 3 p.m., if I feel hungry, then I take, you know, cucumber, raw. Cucumber, you know, tomatoes, means I need raw vegetable only. And you know, actually there is a, I use gram flour.
Gram flour?
Means actually, you know, chana, gram.
Besan, yeah.
Besan, it's not besan. It is the preparation of that is totally different. Besan is totally different. Besan is not very good for health, but that gram flour is very good because the process of making it is different. First, actually, that is it is dipped into water for 24 hours. After that, it is dried in the sun, and after that, means it is roasted. After that, it is converted into flour. Getting my point?
Yeah.
मतलब पहले उसको पानी में डाल के, at least it is in water for 24 hours. After that, it is dried in the sun. उसको सुखा लेते हैं. And after that, it is roasted. फिर उसको भुना जाता है, roast किया जाता है. And after that, it is grinded. Make it so that flour is very, very, very good for health. It doesn't increase your weight, and it gives you calories, energy, everything.
So I
take that flour, mix it with water, and I mix some 1 or 2 spoonful of honey with it, and I take that one bowl.
You don't need to cook that gram flour?
No, there is no need to cook because it is already roasted.
Okay, so it is ready made?
It is ready made. It is ready made and it is very good, so you don't have to waste your time whenever you feel hungry and you need to cook something. Means it is a kind of Indian fast food.
So you can make gram flour and you add hot water.
Not hot, you may take cold water because this is you know, summer season, so you may take cold water, mix it and use some spoon, I mean some honey with it to make it sweet, and then you just drink it. It is really very, very tasty and very, very good for health.
Yeah, I will do also your recipes.
I like it very much. I don't know whether it is available there in your country. I am not sure.
Online?
Online it is maybe available, yes. Gram flour, it is actually in Hindi, it is called chane ka sattu.
Okay, chane ka sattu.
Yeah, in Hindi it is called chane ka sattu.
Talking about sattu.
Yes.
In summer, with lots of ice in it.
Yes, you are absolutely right. That is chane ka sattu.
Yeah, it's very good for health. Right?
And even there is jaw ka sattu also. Jaw.
Jaw ka sattu, okay.
Jaw is also a kind of grain.
Hmm.
जौ का भी सत्तू होता है, चने का भी सत्तू होता है.
And what is your dinner?
Dinner, I am not sure. I take only very big bowl of vegetable. Maybe like lauki, you know lauki?
Yeah.
So sometimes, you know, some other vegetables like tinda and other things, torai. So these vegetables, most of the time green vegetable, you know. I take green vegetable in the evening, or if suppose I need, then only one chapati. Otherwise, I don't take. So this is my diet.
So the monkey and then you cook them, eat raw?
No, not raw. It is not possible to eat raw. We boil it actually. We boil it in cooker, pressure cooker, and we add some, you know, salt, black pepper, or lemon juice, neebu dal ke usme.
Yeah,
I take this. So I try to follow that routine. So it maintains my weight and definitely I feel energetic. I feel energetic. I don't take food outside. I don't prefer fast food like bread, biscuit, and you know, samosa. You know, I think in Pakistan you may be having samosa.
Yeah. Okay, so how do you stop using things, control yourself to buy all those things? How do you do that?
It's a very good question. Actually, now you can say I have no feelings for food. Because now I think that I should eat what really is good for me. So that's why means I don't think much that this is samosa. Even I hate samosa. I tell you. Even, you know, I don't prefer oily food. Whenever I see that something is very oily, I don't see at it. Really, I'm telling you. It is from my, you know, it is from inside. I don't prefer oily food, oily vegetable and all. That's why in the morning, my mother cooks, you know, something special for children, for other family members. They're eating oily and all, but I don't like. That's why, you know, I always have soya cheese and a bowl of curd only. I don't like oily food.
Curd and yogurt is same, right?
Same, yes. Curd, yogurt, yes, same. Dahi jisko bolte aap, dahi. So, means I have no feeling for the food. If it is simple, I have no problem. I'll eat it. Means if people they are unable to control their feelings. Means they feel like eating different kind of food or something. Means their mouth, you know, make water.
Yeah, if they are hungry, then definitely they will, you know, jump into it. But if they are full, then they will think about it. Yeah.
Otherwise, they are always ready to eat. Even some, I have seen some of the people, even there, they means eat over. they have had their lunch. But after 1 or 2 hours, if you ask them to have something which is, you know, very delicious or of their choice, then they start eating it again.
So you eat sweets also?
I eat sometimes, but that is my weakness, you can say. But still, I try to control myself, and instead of that I use honey.
Yeah.
To satiate my hunger, or you know satiate. Satiate means actually apni bhook ko mitana.
I satiate my hunger.
Yes. Or quench means thirst, pyaas ko bujhana.
Okay, these words hard to remember. How do you remember them?
If you practice, you will remember them. There is no need to cram them or learn them. When you use them again and again, they will be on your tongue.
Okay, number third.
Yes.
How can I improve my memory and avoid too much distraction?
First you answer.
I think I need to do some meditation to improve my memory.
The pronunciation is memory.
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 Okay. So you are sorry. Yes, meditation. Yeah.
Yeah. Because I notice my focus. I am not focusing on things. You know, I am always. You know, my mind is like all over. So, if you focus, you learn. But you know, I have stress, anxiety, and not focusing, and I am like distract easily, like a child, you know. So that's why I think it's for me. It's taking time to memorize.
Yeah, actually. You know, if you really means want to improve concentration, that is called concentration. Means nothing can distract you from focusing. So what you should do, of course, meditation is one of the best way to improve your memory as well as your concentration. So meditation, pranayama, it is going to help you, and you should have proper sleep also. Means actually, you know, everything is related to your body, whether it is concentration, whether the, you know, working of your mind properly, or whether it is your energy, whether it is your good health, or whatever it is actually, you know. If you follow a balanced routine, a balanced diet, mean taking proper sleep, having, you know, balanced diet, and we are doing all these things for our brain. For your body actually, but you should have some rest for your brain also. And you, like, you do exercise to keep your body fit and healthy, but you should do something for your brain also, and that is yoga, pranayama. You have to release the negative thoughts from your brain. And for that, you have to do pranayama, meditation. You have to read good motivational books. You have to go for prayer. You should do prayer actually. Means if you believe, whether you do namaz, or I don't know whether you do it or not, but I think you may be doing it. It is also kind of prayer actually. You pray to God. And we have another way to pray. So it means prayer. makes your mind cool.
And yes.
You feel that someone is there to listen to you. So you talk to your, you talk to that Almighty.
Yeah.
And then you will be relaxed. Oh, I have told him everything. Now it is his problem to solve it. It's not my problem. I have told him that this is my problem. Please check it.
You know what happened at work? I started my new job. And they made me lead. And I don't have any experience of leading. Can you believe?
Leading, huh?
How can I lead a group? My English is not good. I don't have that much experience. But you know, some vendor, they portray you very high. In front of client. So now I am under that pressure, like how I will manage that group.
You should not be in pressure. Do your best. And if they like it, it's okay. If they don't like it, no problem. I'll go back to my job. What is the problem? Because that means what you are going to do, that is for time being. You have to go ahead from here. That is for time being, and your life is not confined to that situation only. You have to go ahead. Then why are you buried for that situation? That situation is for time being, that you have to lead them. You do your best. If they like it, it's okay. Otherwise, tell them tata, bye bye, no problem. Why are you taking tension?
Yeah, I shouldn't be taking
because
tension.
Because my life is more important than this job or than this boss.
Yeah, if I'm not having very good English, I will learn with time. It's not like I can learn overnight and, you know, talk them fluently.
Actually, yes, you are right. Everything takes time. Nothing, Rome cannot be built in a day. You know the meaning. Rome cannot be built in a day.
Rome cannot be built in a day, yes.
Rome, maybe I think R-O-M-E.
Rome. R-O-M-E, yes, R-O-M-E.
This is the city. Rome is the capital of Italy. Yeah, and this is a problem. Rome cannot be built in a day. It takes time. Then why to worry? My life is more important. This is not life. Even if you are failure in your life, you need not to worry for that. Because if you understand what life is, you will never complain about your life.
Yeah.
But people actually complain, I don't have a good pair of shoes for me. I have seen people, they have a problem, I have no good pair of shoes for me, but my friends, they have very good pair of shoes. But they don't understand that some of the people are there in the world, they have no legs to put on shoes. Am I right?
Yeah, very right.
So that's why they are worried.
Thanks God, I found you to help me to improve things.
So it means actually you have to, actually you don't have to change the way of what I mean, see, actually, you know, the people who are very happy or they enjoy their life, they are not different from us. they think differently. They do the same thing what we are doing, but their way of thinking is totally different. Their attitude is positive. That's why they enjoy their life. Because today what you have got, you should be happy for that. You should not be sad for that, or should not be sad for what you don't have. But what people do, they are sad for what they don't have. But they have hundred of the things. They are not happy for that. But they are sad for the thing, for one thing which they don't have today.
But you are sweet, frustrated, you want to say something and you don't have words. It's very really frustrating when you want to say something and you don't know how to, because of lack of vocabulary, lack of knowledge.
So why are you asking that question? You are learning, you'll be able to speak. Actually, you should learn that art of speaking. Even sometimes when you don't have words or sentences to speak, then there are a lot of other ways to express. But yeah, you should actually know that how to change the mood immediately, that even your listener cannot understand that you have changed the mood.
I understand what you are trying to say. Just change the subject a little bit. Bring them into some other topics. So, more easier.
Sometimes, actually, you should have some time to think. You know, when suppose people ask you to speak something on a topic, like speak something about population in your country. Suppose this is the topic. And now it is a random topic and you are asked to speak on that topic. And that time you go to stage and you start speaking, but you are afraid what to speak, or I have no idea what to speak. Don't think of all these things. Just go on the stage, and first step means is to wish them hello. Means just have some time to think over that topic. Don't just start speaking about the topic. Oh, population, the country has big population. Don't start speaking like that. Hello. Hello guys, hello friends, whatever. My name is this, and of course it's my pleasure to be here to speak on that topic. Now you are speaking all these things, so you have some time to think or to have an idea to speak about that topic. Getting my point?
Yes.
Or sometimes suppose you don't know what to speak. It is difficult for the people to start or to speak a first sentence. So what should say, oh, my topic is population. You know, population, the world's population has been increasing rapidly. You have started speaking. Now, so when you are speaking first sentence, you are getting the idea for the second. When you are speaking the second sentence, you are getting the idea to speak third sentence. And start speaking. Or instead of just speaking, I tell you a very good trick. When you are going to speak in public, don't just try to speak yourself. Have conversation with the people. That is very good idea. So instead of keeping speaking, ask people to ask you some questions, or you ask people questions. That is the nice way, or best way to speak.
Yes, I will, because I notice what I like, I like to be alone. Like, you know, I always want my alone time. So that's not, I mean, it is not good for me. Because, I mean, I cannot learn. If I have this kind of attitude, I cannot learn English. Because to learn English, I need to talk. I need to talk more.
Yes. Definitely. Okay, so only 2-3 questions you asked me, huh? And time is over.
And I have 25 questions.
So that's why I ask you. You see that when you write questions, we have idea to discuss.
Correct.
Then what we are going to discuss, this is the best way to improve.
Yeah.
So when you have a problem, write some more questions. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
We'll discuss some more questions. So yeah. are you enjoying means your classes?
Yeah, I'm very thankful to you because I think I'm improving now.
Good. And I hope you are not going to learn only, but you are going to learn some other things also. The basic concepts of the life, which may be helpful you to lead a very enjoyable and comfortable life.
Right, yeah.
So you are going to learn a lot of other things also along with it.
Just like today I learned these all recipes, what is good for your health?
Yes, because actually we have to share all these things with the people.
Yeah.
If we know something good, it is to be shared, you know, with the people.
Mm-hmm.
Let them know that what is right, what is wrong, if you know. And then they have to decide what they should do. Okay then, see you again tomorrow the same time.
Thank you sir, thank you so much. Bye.
Bye, good night.